morning, everyone. Well, lunch is brunch is turned into lunch, but there's so many things going on. Oh, by the way, I'm Jesse James, and I'm the Associate Vice President here at the University of Dubuque, and there's so many special events on campus going on, and we had a very special one this morning, and this is another very special event. And what makes this is special that we're going to recognize alums who have done great things, but it's also special to see the sound folks try to get this to work inside of a tent. Great acoustics here, you know. So welcome again this morning to the UD's Alumni Recognition Ceremony. It's our opportunity to say thank you and to show appreciation every year for alums who have done wonderful things. That you've made great achievements, and we appreciate you coming. You serve your community in every way. You serve your church, you serve the university, and you serve our nation. We get a lot of nominations for awards, and it's very, very difficult to select award recipients every year. You know, it goes back to the history of this university when a fellow, I didn't personally know him, but his name was Adrian Van Vliet, and he began educating pastors, German to minister to Germans who were heading west. You remember? You don't remember, but anything this side of the Mississippi was the west. So they were moving to an undeveloped, yet undeveloped country. They need ministry, and that's where the University of Dubuque's mission remains at our core today of service. We're so proud of the alums that have gone on, you know, and they've gone on to do many great things. You know, some have gone on to fame and fortune, and they so generously shared their time and treasure with others. Many of our alums are serving their communities and their churches and our nation, one person at a time, one place at a time, seeking through their life's journey to leave a legacy, expressing their appreciation for and sharing of their God-given talents. Their teachers and their coaches in small and large communities around the globe, some working with at-risk kids, underrepresented populations, while others teaching the gift of reading and writing to children in undeveloped countries of the world. Their pastors serving people during the best times of their lives and during the worst times of their lives. UD alumni bring people together, making the world a smaller place by piloting planes, transporting people all over the world. They enter the world of business, bringing with them the core values of good character and ethics fostered while they were students here at the University of Dubuque. And finally, if you had the pleasure of attending this morning, you got to meet some of them. They've served and continue to serve with distinction, courage, and excellence in the armed forces that protect our nation and our way of life. So now you see why it's difficult when we get nominations each year to select the alums that we're going to recognize. So at this point, I'd like to invite Reverend Gunn up for the invocation.
Thank you. If you would, please pray with me. Almighty God, merciful Lord, as we gather and enjoy this fellowship, may we recognize that we have fellowship with you, that you are in our midst. That is what I pray for, that is what I ask. For this food that we are about to partake in, to eat, I pray that you'd bless it to our bodies. We are thankful for it in all the ways that you provide for each one of us here. I pray, Lord, that you would bless our fellowship as a gift to one another, and again, that you would bless this food to our bodies. May all that we do ultimately be a life lived in grateful response to what you have done for us. Amen. Thank you.
It's my pleasure to intro our next speaker. I won't use any cliches, but he's a man who needs no introduction. He's not the heartbeat of America, but he is the heartbeat, in my opinion, of the University of Dubuque, and keeps us on a straight and narrow track on our mission. I've had the privilege of working with Dr. Buol for all the years that he's been president here. So with no further ado, Dr. Buol.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Jesse. Welcome, everyone. And for Peter and your crew, thank you for this wonderful venue. I will admit, when I heard that we were going to be doing this outside in October, I'm like, okay, we'll see how that goes. But you transform this space and this lovely green space on the north end of the Charles and Ramona Meyers Center to a great place, and I say we just leave it up here all the time. It might get kind of expensive heating the place, but it's beautiful. And you know, one of the things somebody was talking to me as I walked in and said, "Oh, so you have a few remarks?" And kind of the running joke amongst college presidents is we're always called upon to do a few remarks. Well, you know, my guess is you've probably heard more than your share of remarks. And so I'll try to emphasize the few here now. What I would want to say is it's already been a tremendous homecoming. Our board met this week as well. And as you can probably experience and see just on campus, the University of Dubuque is really at a really amazing time in its history. And we're all really grateful and proud to have the privilege of being a part of this special institution in this time in our history. But it would not be possible were it not for the absolute singularity of purpose and focus of our trustees and the mission that all binds us together. So when you have a chance, when there are a number of our trustees who are here, can all the trustees who are here raise your hands? Just I won't embarrass you and introduce you, but please, yes, thank them. It's I've learned a lot from these people, and it's a joy to be able to serve with them. You know, so much of the university's mission, and we talk to this, we try to just really drive this home to our students regularly. And you know, we really believe that we have been created in the image of God, and that this life is a gift. And that education is a gift. But we also believe that as part of that gift is we have a responsibility to do something with that which we've been given. And that in a nutshell is the essence of a University of Dubuque education and the ethos of this place. We all have been given the gift and the privilege of life. We have the exceptional opportunity certainly to live in a wonderful country, in a wonderful state, in a wonderful part of the state. And now we have a responsibility because we've had the privilege of learning in the presence of amazing people and an amazing history. We have a responsibility to invest in those around us. And that, in a nutshell, is what we're about. And that's one of the things that makes this event such a wonderful highlight for me personally over the course of the year, is that you'll get to see and experience together and celebrate together alums who've made investments in their communities and their families and in their world around them. And so I want to congratulate each one of you for this honor. I want to thank you for being here, and thank you for doing what you do on behalf of your organizations and for what you do on behalf of the University of Dubuque. So congratulations. God bless you all. And Spartan Nation, be proud. We're playing Wartburg. They're very good. But, you know, we can be pretty good, too. So who knows? All things are possible, and as we learned in the dedication service earlier, this is, you know, as a Christian school, we believe in miracles. So this is, today's the day, so thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bullock. Before I introduce the next person, those of you who checked in through at the Heritage Center, I asked my lovely wife here to volunteer this year to take pictures. So you indirectly met her if you checked in. She was behind the camera that took your picture. So a minute ago I said, well, what did you think about your day and a half of snapping photographs? And she made two comments that were interesting. She said, I marveled at the number of couples that met here at the University of Dubuque and have been married for 40, 50, 60 years, and they're still together. And there was just so many of them. And I thought that was a wonderful experience for her to have. Now, the second comment, I think, was a backdoor compliment to women, because she said, well, at a point, all the men just started looked the same. So I don't think that's a compliment to us men. Well, listen, the next gentleman does, I think, need an introduction, because in the umpteen years that I've had the pleasure of working with Peter and his late wife, Susan, they've always been behind the scenes, keeping the engine tuned up and keeping the place running and leading the organization to success. So it's been my privilege to work with both of them. And Peter Smith is going to serve today doing the awards, and some of them are going to be a lot of fun, and some of them, if you attended the dedication ceremony this morning, are difficult. So, Peter.
It's always a little scary when someone who you've worked with for 17 years decides they're going to introduce you. So we survived it. Here we are. Well, this is really, it's a great honor and a lot of fun for me, because we always talk about our alums as our product. And risking getting corrected on this by people who've lived a life in agriculture, I grew up in the woods in northern New Hampshire in a small city, so I mean, it took me a while to figure out the difference between beans and corn. So I'm working on it. When I said to someone the other day, the beans look good, they looked at me skeptically, so I don't know. In my own mind, I've always thought of UD as sort of a seed corn factory. We develop the seeds here. We not only are we into instruction, but we're into learning. But most particularly, we're into formation. And that these seeds get thrown out at commencement all over the country, all over the world, and hopefully they make this world a better place because they've been here, and then we've done our job. So that's the fun part with this. Betty Takis, could you come up for just a minute? Everybody needs one. Betty Takis is known to many of the people in this. Okay. Well, thank you very much. Everyone needs a nurse, right? So I have one. Betty graduated magna cum laude from the University of Dubuque with a Bachelor of Science degree in nursing in 1973.
Nine?
Yeah. Nine. Good. Thank you. Were you married at the time and working as a nurse?
I was married, had three children, and worked as a nurse.
Thank you. I just wanted to be sure I was correct with that.
I'm sorry. I'm
No, you don't have to keep quiet. It's okay. I need all the help I can get here. Since the 1970s, Betty has been instrumental in developing the hospice concept in this city and Hospice of Dubuque. And as Jesse suggested, hospice has been very important in our family, and it was the thing that made it possible for Susan to be at home and to die in a place that she wanted to. She didn't want to die in, but at least she could die in something that was familiar. So Betty, I thank you personally.
Thank you
very much for your staff.
Very kind.
I won't read all of Betty's credentials, but I do want to call attention to a couple of things. In 2014, she received the National Council of Hospice and Palliative Care Professionals and National Hospice Founders Award. And that is a huge national award. And they found someone in Dubuque and in Iowa.
Thank you.
And most recently, in 2015, she's received the Volunteer of the Year Award at Hospice of Dubuque. And that, in this state, is the top award. So thank you so much for your service to this community, to people who, to families who really need your help, and for bringing a distinguished career and honor to the university.
Thank you. I'm short, so I have to stand tall. I was a non-traditional student in 1970 when I came back to school, because the University of Dubuque had a nursing step 2 program where RNs could come and we could get our BSN, and I wanted to get my BSN. In our senior year, we had a project and a paper to write and to do a change project in healthcare, a needed health change in healthcare, and I picked hospice. Hospice of New Haven, Connecticut had just opened in the 70s and was modeled after St. Christopher's in London that Dr. Cicely Saunders had opened and developed. And so therefore, it was a big challenge to get everyone on the same page, for because this was a new philosophy of care, and so we were able to do it with much help, and I initiated the concept, but I got 4 nurses to help me develop the program, and so it's still alive, it's very viable, and it continues to focus on compassionate care for patient and family and symptom control for the patient. It is the only nonprofit hospice in the Dubuque area. Thank you.
President Bullock, would you come up and help me present Betty's award?
Can do whatever you want.
I have to tell you, I was on the alumni committee that interviewed Mr. Bullock when he applied for this position.
Alumni Professional Achievement Awards. Brett Bacon. Brett Bacon graduated from the University of Dubuque in 1969. Betty, I just want to let you know that I got that one right, with highest honors in economics and history, and was involved in Greek life as a member of the 13ers fraternity. Are there any other 13ers here? You can make a little noise, it's okay. After graduating from UD, he received his JD from Northwestern University School of Law in 1972, joined the Thomas Hine Law Firm, and left that after a time as a founding partner of Franz Ward Limited Liability Corporation. He has earned the highest Martindale-Hubbell rating and has been listed for several years in both Best Lawyers of America and Ohio Super Lawyers. But he's also been active outside of his profession as a trustee for many boards, but I'll pick two, Cleveland Playhouse and Pepper Pike Civic Theater. He and his spouse Bonnie reside in Cleveland, Ohio, and they are parents of three sons, Jeffrey, Scott, and Mitch. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Peter, and thanks for all the 13ers that are here. Coming back to the campus, I would particularly like to thank the trustees, the staff, and the faculty here at Dubuque, because it's become a fantastic place to come back and visit, and the students here are outstanding. I think President Bullock said it well when you're planting seeds for the future. I hope the students here today enjoy this place as much as I did. Thank you very much.
Lynn, could you come up? Lynn Fuller is known to many people here in Dubuque, and he is a legend in banking. And I've heard about him for years, and I have also discovered that he's a 50-year member of the ski patrol at sundown. And I'm a lifelong skier, and we were talking at lunch, and I said, you know, knowing that there's a 50-year member of Ski Patrol at sundown, I think I'm gonna try snowboarding. Because I know he can pick up the pieces afterwards. And he did give me good advice on how to protect my wrists and all that sort of thing. Oftentimes, I think everybody in the world is from Jackson, Minnesota, where Jeff was raised, but I'm now beginning to believe that they don't all live in Jackson. The rest of the world comes from Maquoketa. So this is part of my continuing education at UD. Lynn graduated from senior high school in Maquoketa, came to the University of Dubuque, and graduated in 1971 with a Bachelor of Science degree, cum laude, majoring in biology. And he will be glad to share with you how he got from biology to banking. And then received his Master of Business degree from the University of Iowa in 1980. When Lynn came to Dubuque Bank and Trust, it was just DB&T, and it was a small bank. Under his leadership and with a great team of people, they now are part of Heartland Financial, involved certainly headquartered in Dubuque, but operating from here to New Mexico to Montana, a terrific bank holding company with a fabulously good reputation. He is chairman and CEO of Heartland Financial, and was chairman and president and CEO of Heartland from 2000 to 2014, but continues to hold positions as chairman or vice chairman of most of the company's subsidiaries. So it's with great pleasure it's for us to honor you for banking. But if you look at the list of things that Lynn is involved in, and this is another part of the conversation at lunch, Dubuque, I think, is the most happening place in the state of Iowa. How does that happen? Well, it happens because business people are involved in their business and do well, but they're also committing themselves to serving the community. And if you look at that list of things that Lynn's involved with, my question to him was, do you sleep? So it's a pleasure for us to recognize you with an Alumni Professional Achievement Award.
Thank you, Peter. Peter and I had a nice discussion over lunch, and our family's four generations of bankers. I don't know what's wrong with us genetically, but we start out in medicine, and then we shift over to banking. I'll never forget my father saying, you're going into medicine because there's no money in banking. And one of the most challenging things, I think, of graduates from undergraduate is, what do I really want to do with my career? And I was very fortunate. We had a close friend here in Dubuque, the Faber family, Dr. Faber, LC, let me work during the summer for him and get an experience of what it'd be like to be in medicine. As Peter said, I've been a National Ski Patroller for 50 years, 45 years next year in banking. And so I thought, well, that's natural. You're a ski patroller. You box people up, put bandages on them, wrap them up, get them to the hospital. Might as well go all the way to the hospital and take care of them there. Well, I did get a chance in my senior year, graduating from the UD, to go work at the bank. And it was a much different social environment than medicine. And so for whatever reason, I decided to go on into banking. And over lunch, Peter and I talked, and I said, you know, work really isn't work when you love what you do. It's more fun. And so you need less sleep when you really enjoy what you're doing. But my son followed. He went into medicine and actually got his MD at Michigan, along with his MBA. And I coaxed him to come back into banking. So we've got four generations in banking. And again, I'm flattered the university would recognize me with this award. It's very, very nice of all of you. And I was a townie when I went to college here. So I didn't get involved with the 13ers and the rest of the folks here at the college. But it was a great education. And background in science and math is a great start to problem solving. And that's what we've done through the years. And so it's been a lot of fun. And thanks. Thank you for inviting me. Peter, thank you.
Celina Peerman. Pleasure to be able to welcome you. And just for the record, Betty, I'm going to get her graduation year right. It's 1992, and she graduated with a bachelor's degree in psychology and international studies. She has a master's degree and a PhD in psychology. She founded the Peerman Group, which provides personalized and customized training solutions to meet a wide range of employee, supervisor, and executive professional development needs. She's worked internationally in Southeast Asia, and particularly in southern Belize, where she's been continuing her passion for small business development. She and her spouse, David, reside in Waverly and are the parents of two daughters, Elizabeth.
Who are the ones over there with the cameras?
And Eddie. You know, there are no cameras. They're just cell phones.
They're cell phones, right, exactly.
So it's a pleasure for us to have you here. Welcome home. And thank you for everything you're doing.
Thank you very much. It was a surprise and very much humbled by the honor. I admit, I, at the age of 45, didn't expect something like this to come up at this point in time. But it was really University of Dubuque that imposed upon me for the years I was here to continue to make a positive difference for others. And it was the experience that I have been able to enjoy with my family who's here today, for the faculty members who also made such a difference along the way, and for really what we try to live every day. And in every interaction we have with people, we have the opportunity to strengthen that relationship or take away from it. And so we all have that opportunity to continue to build relationships around us and make a positive difference where we can. And even though my daughters over there would tell you that I do talk for a living, this is not my comfort zone today. So I have been blessed to be able to work with hundreds of companies in trying to figure out how do we get to performance and how do we build those relationships every day, even when the technology seems to creep in from all places, those relationships still matter. And I'm absolutely grateful for my time at the University of Dubuque and have just been thrilled to be reconnected in these recent years to help support the efforts here. So thank you very much for this.
Roy, Roy usually is the one who gets to do the talking. Today, he's going to have to suffer through the listening. This seems to be the litany of non-traditional students. Roy, I think, has the land record now for the time he started at UD and the year in which he finished. Roy graduated with a BBA in 1992, but he started this journey in 1968. And he took a few years off to work at John Deere, raise a family, and then came back and graduated from UD in 1992. When he was taking his classes at UD, he was also working full-time at John Deere. And once he retired and finally hung up his spurs in 2002, President invited Roy to come back and give us a hand with our grounds and how we look in terms of plantings. And I think if any of you have spent any time in the last day or two around this campus, you can see Roy's work. Not only does he know stuff about plants, but and trimming and all that sort of thing, he also has provided tremendous leadership for the grounds crew. That group of guys, they are all guys, by the way, takes tremendous pride in how this place looks. And for those of us who are in the business of presenting the university to people, all of us in our unit, whether it be admission, financial planning, or advancement, just are so grateful to you for making us look good every day. So thank you. Roy is another guy who doesn't sleep, I think. But in 1995, Roy ran successfully for a ward seat on the city council against a 14-year incumbent, and he won by 110 votes. Winning by one was okay, but 110 is nice. And he was reelected again in 1999 and again in 2003. He was elected mayor in 2005, and in 2006, Sustainable Dubuque was born, a three-part model that balances economic prosperity with environmental integrity and social and cultural vibrancy. I think of where you should be wearing something green, I think. I don't know. He's also co-chair of the Mississippi River Cities and Towns Initiative, and represents the city at the U.S. Conference of Mayors, National League of Cities, and the Iowa League of Cities as well. Roy has, his commitment to sustainability has made Dubuque a national leader in sustainability. And real growth and real reputation for a city or for a university for that matter is organic. And that's kind of a pun, I didn't mean it that way, but it comes from the inside out. And we haven't advertised ourselves particularly as a green city, but we are a sustainable city. And Roy has led that effort, and I think he has a partner who's here today who's been very active in that as well. And Mike Van Milligan, our longtime city manager, is here. And stand up and let people take a look at him. So Roy, without any further embarrassment to you, it's a pleasure to award you an alumni award for service to the community.
Well, thank you, Peter, and thank you to the entire University of Dubuque community for this tremendous honor. Certainly something I was not expecting. But I also wanted to thank not only the university community, but my family. As Peter alluded to, it is a time-consuming occupation, dual occupation that I have, and my family, especially our children and our grandchildren, I've missed opportunities, you know, to be with them because there are other more pressing things that go on in the city, or, you know, that type of thing. So I want to thank all of them for their support. But first and foremost, I want to thank my lovely wife, Deborah, who really was the one that encouraged me to go back and finish my degree. She encouraged me to run for the office of mayor after I had already been on the city council, knowing that it was going to be a very time-consuming job because I try not to do anything halfway. I usually give 110%. So it's really been a tremendous honor for me to receive this award, but there are so many other people that have made that possible, and I want to thank all of them. And I really love what I do here at the University of Dubuque and what I do for the city. Thank you all.
This is the fun part now. I've had the privilege of working closely with Jeffrey Bullock the last 17 years, and someone who has been of tremendous assistance to me, and is certainly of tremendous assistance to him, is Deborah Buol. How many people here are familiar with the Stephen Sorkin series West Wing? Well, I want you to know you're going to get to meet Mrs. Landingham. Can you come up? You don't know how hard it is to get something past this person, but it's a real achievement for us to be able to honor you as an honorary alumna today. So if you can speak if you want. But just on a personal note for me, and I'm sure Jeff has a million stories and a million gratitudes to Deb, but Deb knows more about the university and its history than most people. She's forgotten more than most of us will ever know. And she has been unfailingly kind to Susan and me in when we came here, and she has been very helpful professionally to me. Every association with her has been wonderful, and she is a real detail nut. And you know that when she says something, it's actually factual, documentable, take it to the bankable. And so it's a real personal pleasure to be part of this award. I do think we kept it a secret from her. I don't know how we did. Anderson Sancy. Anderson Sancy is a graduate of the class of 2010 and received his Master of Arts in Communication in 2012. Currently, he works for the City of Dubuque as Resource Management Coordinator for the Public Works Department. He's heavily involved in the Dubuque Dream Center and is a member of the Dubuque Black Men's Coalition. As a member of the Black Men's Coalition, a group of African American leaders use the diverse talents to empower young African American boys. As a member of the Black Men's Coalition, Anderson developed two programs. The first program is the Road to Success for Teens, to provide teens with employment skills such as how to write a resume, how to prepare an interview, and how to identify leadership skills, how to start a business. The other has received some national attention, the Back to School Bash event. The program has impacted over 300 families in need and has worked with over 20 organizations in order to connect people to people, people to resources. In 2015, a portion of the program went viral across the country for the barber who exchanged free haircuts for reading. In 2013, Anderson received the Employee Sustainability Award from the City of Dubuque. And this is an award that I know I'm never going to get it, but I'm interested in it. The Ideal Man Award at the All Girls Rock event. Personally, I just like an invitation to the event. Actually, it's presented by the Young Women's Association at the University of Dubuque. So it's a pleasure to present you with an alumni volunteer recognition. Anderson has also got a little project going here at UD, and that is he is working with other African American alumni to develop a scholarship program to support African American students at the University of Dubuque.
So just to mention, my wife was not happy when I got that award by the women. But first of all, I just want to thank the University of Dubuque and just all the people that came out to support me today. As Mr. Fuller said, when you enjoy what you do, you don't need sleep, right? So I enjoy working for the City of Dubuque. I enjoy helping people that are struggling. And the reason why I enjoy doing that, because I was that kid who was struggling. I was that kid who grew up in poverty with a single mother, you know, trying to raise three knuckleheads, you know. I was the kid who got an opportunity from the University of Dubuque, and it changed my life tremendously. And I used those skills that I learned here at the University of Dubuque to impact the world, because my mom always told me, you don't have to have a lot to impact people. And like Peter said, he was kind of the inspiration as well why I started this scholarship, because as we were talking, he mentioned, Anderson, you're gonna have the people who donate, you know, the millions and millions of dollars, but you can make a difference as well. And it hit me, wow, I can't. And we end up starting our scholarship, and we have a lot of alumni who are being engaged and that they want to participate as well. But also, I didn't do this by myself, and they didn't know I was going to do this, but I do want to thank the people that helped me throughout my career and still today helped me to be the man that I am today. The first people, my mentors, Andre Lassier and Mike Van Milligan. John Stewart is here as well. If you want to know what the future is going to be like tomorrow, ask yourself, who are you investing in today? These guys don't have to, but they put time to invest in me. They mentor me, they guide me, they let me know when I'm wrong, and they also empower me to be the best every single day. So without those guys every single day, I'm nothing. Next, my beautiful wife. There's times where I wanted to give up, you know. There's times where I feel like, man, the work that's going on in this community is just too much. I don't know how I can do this. But she said, Anderson, what happened to your faith? Faith has brought you here, and faith is going to continue to take you where you need to go. So that's kind of the inspiration that I needed, and ever since then, I just ran with that. Next, my brother. And then I hope you guys don't mind, but Mark, can you come up here real quick, please? This is my older brother, ladies and gentlemen. So as I mentioned, he didn't know I was gonna do this. You know, I grew up in poverty with this guy right here, and he was the father in the house, the big brother in the house, and times when my mom wasn't around, he was the mom. You know, he's one of the reasons why I came to Dubuque, so I kind of blame him as well sometimes, especially during the snow, like, you're the one who brought me here. But, you know, at least once a day, he texts me. And my brother wants to start his own business. He wants to start a weight room program to help people with obesity and also just treat people, or actually help people with a healthier lifestyle. And he texted me and was like, man, I can't wait till one day we make it. I can't wait till one day where we can give so much back to people, man. And it's kind of that motivation. And he says, but until then, the struggle is the motivation, man. Keep doing what you're doing. And he inspires me every single day. You know, I try to be good, but he motivates me to be great every single day. And one of the hard days of my life was in 2010, kind of get me emotional a little bit, but my mom wasn't able, or any of my family member was able to make it when I graduated. Not a lot of people know that. And not because they didn't want to come, but because they couldn't afford it. My family couldn't afford to come watch me graduate, and it kind of hurt me, you know? All I had was my wife there and my son. I didn't have my mom. My dad's never been there for me, nor, you know, the guy who kind of raised me. But every single day, he reminds me, you're strong. Go make that impact. So as I get this award, I never had the opportunity to touch the president's hand or hug my brother. So thanks, man.
I'm Rauen. It's not a far walk, really. Tom graduated from the University of Dubuque in 2005 with a Bachelor of Arts degree in Computer Graphics and Interactive Media. He was a member of the Student Ambassador Association, Athenian Fraternity, and was on the Dean's List most of the time. After graduation, founded Envision Sports Design. And if you are wearing a t-shirt for homecoming, it was made by Envision Design. In 2014, the Dubuque Chamber of Commerce presented Envision Sports Design with a Members Choice Award for Business of the Year. He also serves his community. Board of Directors for the Dubuque WCA, YMCA, Dubuque Area Triathlon Club, Dubuque County Fair Association. He also doesn't sleep. He also has the world's record let me see if I get this right, for wearing the largest number of t-shirts at one time. How many was that?
247.
247 t-shirts. You're forcing me to ask, how many t-shirts do you have on right now?
Two.
Two, wow. Okay, good. There are many amazing accomplishments, but in September of 2015, Tom competed in the Hennepin 100, a 50-mile race in Sterling, Illinois, and he finished the race first place overall with a time of 6 hours, 57 minutes, and 18 seconds. Tom, I just want to tell you that if I had started that race, I would have arrived just in time for lunch today. So congratulations.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure to present you with an Alumni Award of Merit.
Thank you. I want to thank the University of Dubuque and my wife, Amanda. I met her here, so you know, I owe it to UD for where I met my lovely wife. I got to thank my parents, Steve and Joanne, helping instill kind of the hardworking morals, values, all that. And you know, when I left from them to go to UD, UD picked up right where they left off and continued to build that character to let me develop who I am today through the student ambassadors, through the athlete fraternity, through all the other faculty and staff here that I looked up to and grew. And from there, I think with all the other award winners, you know, I can say we don't do this to what we've done and what we've accomplished to win awards. I think we do it to be the best version of ourselves that we can be, and to help impact the others around us to be the best versions of themselves that they can be. So it comes natural and it comes easy when you just try to be the best, and when you, you know, strive to make those around you better. So thanks, UD, and keep growing. And I love the way the campus looks. I run by it every morning, and it's absolutely impactful and inspiring to see the campus continue to grow and the college continuing to grow too. Thank you.
This is just a wonderful day all the way around. Mark Carlson. Mark is the first of a number of veterans awards that we're going to present today. Many of us had the wonderful experience this morning of being present for the dedication of the Sergeant Jeffrey B. Dodge Veterans Center in Blades Hall. A very moving ceremony for all of us, and a chance now after 50 years to finally pay our respects for Vietnam veterans who often didn't get that respect paid to them when they came home. So it was a tremendous experience this morning. Mark Carlson graduated cum laude from the University of Dubuque in 1985 and was recipient of the University Aviation Award, the George C. Marshall ROTC Leadership Award, and the State of Iowa ROTC Governor's Cup Award. And for those of you who aren't familiar with what the Governor's Cup is, it is awarded to the top ROTC student in the state of Iowa. So it is a tremendous honor. Mark served 25 years as an active duty and reserve engineer officer, retiring in December of 2010. In 06, he received a master's degree in strategic studies from the U.S. Army War College in Carlisle, Pennsylvania. He is the holder of the Legion of Merit, a Bronze Star, the Meritorious Service Medals, the Army Commendation and Achievement Medals. And upon retiring from the Army in 2010, Mark continued his passion for service as through various service organizations for veterans in the state of Minnesota, most notably the United Veterans Legislative Council. He's active in the Military Action Group at the Minnesota State Capitol, which meets to craft and lobby legislation to make Minnesota more veteran-friendly. So it is a pleasure for the university to award you a Veterans Award for Distinguished Service.
Thank you very much. I first want to thank the University of Dubuque for putting this event together, and especially I want to thank my parents, you know, for which none of this would be possible. You know, my parents modeled good Christian values, hard work, sacrifice, and I learned everything from them. So I thank them, and they're here with me today. And my wife, Lisa, who also had to sacrifice a lot during all these years, and she's here with me. She's always been an encourager and inspiration to keep me going. And being at the dedication ceremony this morning for the Jeffrey B. Dodge Veterans Center, it taught me a lot. I had not been back here to the university in 30 years. I graduated 30 years ago this past May, and this is the first day that I've been back. And I love what I see. You know, I love what's happening to the campus. The campus is growing. It's a beautiful campus. But the Dodge Center just proves that the University of Dubuque is a high impact university. It's a committed university. You know, it's not the type of person that hangs a yellow ribbon on their car. It's the type of person that jumps in and takes action. And the University of Dubuque absolutely does that, and I'm proud to be an alumnus from that. So thank you all very much.
Nick Yiannias. It's a pleasure to present Nick Yiannias a Veterans Award for Distinguished Service. And if he'll indulge me a small story, I ran into Nick and Christine when they were out for dinner one evening, and I said, Nick, we're so happy to be able to present this award. And he looked at me, smiled, and said, do you think I'll be alive then? I said,
that was 6 months ago.
Yeah. I didn't know I was going to have a fellow comedian here. But that's okay. I don't mind sharing the stage. But my response to Nick was, well, you gotta be, because the others are going to be done except for one posthumously. So we should have at least two that people can hear speak. And so Nick is here today. Nick graduated from the University of Dubuque in 1947 with a bachelor's degree in economics and general science. He participated in Navy V-12 training at UD, then went on to the Navy Communications School at Harvard. He served in World War II and 2 years in Korea, and he was the cryptographer courier to the United Nations peace talks in Panmunjom, North Korea, and has nearly 20 years of military service. Nick was very involved in the commercial development of Dubuque's West Side, which for those of us who came after it was thoroughly developed, find interesting. And he operated the first movie theater multiplex in the state of Iowa, and continues to serve as a member of motion picture pioneers. He's received the Governor's Leadership Award from the Iowa Community Betterment Program, served as chair of the Five Flags Executive Committee and Findlay Hospital, and there are many more. It is, and also is, has served, how many years have you been a trustee?
As a trustee, quite a few.
Nick has been, I was just asking Nick how many years he'd been a trustee at the university, and he just said quite a few. So it's been a while. So he has had many years of service to this place. Nick, it is just a personal pleasure to be able to present you with the Veterans Award for service.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you. This award is being presented today to four others posthumously. So what does that tell you? I don't know. President Bullock, faculty, veterans, students, and friends. Flashback to the early 40s. The World War II was underway then. Enlistments and draftees were being taken into the service. And on this campus, female enrollment may have been a few hundred students, just a few hundred women, and about a dozen men. Just think of that. 300 women, approximately, and maybe a dozen men students. They'd all been drafted by then or volunteered to go into the service. War is a great interrupter of lives. To the rescue, the U.S. Navy, with its officers' training program called V-12, gradually that year, a total of 600 young men enrolled in V-12, 18, 19, 20 years old, appeared on the UD campus. Big impact, 600 men. I was one of them, and I presume that's why I am here today. Thank you for this humbling honor, President Bullock. I deeply appreciate it. In the context of the University of Dubuque, however, in my mind, this honor also includes the V-12 students, especially the deceased members who made the ultimate sacrifice of their lives. Their names are listed on the anchor at the Veterans Training Center. They are truly our heroes, and they serve as a reminder to us that freedom is not free. Let me say that again. Freedom is not free. Thank you again, President.
Would a representative from the Dodge family please come up? It's a pleasure to introduce to you Pete Dodge, Jeff's brother, who received this award on behalf of the family. Jeff came to the University of Dubuque from Yonkers, New York. He's a member of the class of 1968. He's also a member of the 13ers fraternity, and is in his senior year served as pledge master. After graduation, Jeff enlisted in the Army in October of 1968, completing his basic training at Fort Leonard Wood, Missouri. On April 25th, 1970, Sergeant Jeffrey Dodge was killed in Binh Duong, South Vietnam, on his 366th day in country, and he was 23. For many years since, his name has been enshrined in the Vietnam Monument on the North Campus Quad. Today, we brought that name to life in the Jeffrey B. Dodge Veterans Center, which gives the university and his family and those of us who are investors in the center a chance to do work that he would have done had he had the chance. We're doing this forward for him. So it's a pleasure to recognize him and to present you with this Veterans Award for Distinguished Service.
Thank you, Peter. Needless to say, I'm very proud of my brother's service. We talked about it earlier today. I'm equally as proud, and I'm sure my family certainly was, from his career here at the University of Dubuque. He was the first male in our family after probably 1920 to actually graduate from class and college. I do not have the honor of having a graduated from. I originally started at Tufts, the class of 62, then transitioned to the class of 63, then transitioned to the class of 64, and then my father said, join the Navy. So any academic aspect of this, my two sisters who are educators, college graduates, master's degrees, and Jeff having a successful degree here, are just wonderful. So I'm really honored for our family that all the honors that have been bestowed on us as a result of Jeff's very proud service in the U.S. Army. Thank you very much.
Would a representative from the Downey family please come up? Michael Downey came to Dubuque from Needham, Massachusetts in 1961. He was a member of the class of 1966, hoping at one point to become a teacher. He was also a member of the Athenaeum fraternity all 4 years he was here. Following graduation, Michael received his Marine Commission in August of 1966 with the rank of lieutenant. On July 1, 1967, at the age of 24, Downey was killed in Quang Nam in the Republic of South Vietnam. He was posthumously awarded the Bronze Star, which was presented to his wife, Janice. He was cited for courage, initiative, and professional ability. It is a pleasure for us to present this award for distinguished service to his sister.
I'm going to step out of my comfort zone and say thank you to the university and thank you to everyone here for their support, not only to my brother and Jan, but for the Dodge family and the Meyers and the Sagers family. But I ask that no one here ever forget the sacrifices that the veterans have fought and continue to fight today so that each and every one of us continue to have the freedoms that we have. And let us continue to help support our veterans and their families, however small the act or the deed may be, so that they know that their sacrifices have not been done in vain. Thank you.
Would a representative of the Meyers family please come forward? Roger Meyers was a student at the University of Dubuque, graduating with a bachelor's degree in economics in 1955. He also was a member of the 13ers fraternity. Roger joined the U.S. Navy and became a Navy aviator, earning his wings in June of 1957. In 1960, Meyers married Pat. He rotated between different units and locations for a time, but was assigned to Attack Squadron 164 as an A-4E Skyhawk pilot in early 1969. On the night of February 9th, while preparing to launch an attack, Meyers' aircraft crashed during takeoff from the USS Hancock, and neither his body nor his aircraft have ever been recovered. It is a pleasure for us, Pat, to present you this award.
There are really no words that I can express that I'm just so impressed with everything that's been done, with the wonderful people I've met, the families, and it's so much, how can I say it? They were kind of forgotten when all of the Vietnam vets came home, and to be honored now, they're, like I said, it's wonderful. And I thank each and every one of you. I'm very fortunate. I have my son and my daughter here with me, and my granddaughter. I have very good friends that my son grew up with, Dr. and Mrs. Marvin O'Hare. I'm from California, so this is a beautiful campus. When Roger first brought me here, I believe that Dubuque was one block square. I know I might be wrong, but it seemed that I saw that very quickly. But again, thank you. You all have a place in my heart always. Thank you.
Would a representative of the Sagers family please come forward? We have Ron's two nieces here. At home with family members this afternoon. As Royce mentioned this morning in his talk, 8 years ago, we had a chance to dedicate the Sagers conference room in the Calapity Rec and Wellness Center. So it's especially wonderful to have you here today with us. Ron Sagers was a member of the class of 1968, and as I was saying during Lynn Fuller's introduction, this person too is from Maquoketa. Came to UD to begin a major in business, but settled on a degree in physical education, was active on the wrestling team, participating all 4 years on campus. He was a member of the Athenaean fraternity. Sagers was drafted in October of 1968 and was sent to Vietnam in November of 1969. He was a staff sergeant with the 1st Air Cav. Sagers was among the first U.S. troops to enter the country of Cambodia, and on May 22, 1970, he was killed in the Fishhook region of that country. And it is a pleasure he was survived by his wife, Lynn, who I believe is here today as well. Lynn, would you stand up just so people could recognize you? It's a pleasure for the university to present you a Veterans Award for Distinguished Service for your uncle.
I just want to say on the behalf of Uncle Ronnie, we thank you for this. And we'd like to present Roger Parker. He was one of Uncle Ronnie's best friends over in Cambodia, and he's the one that brought Uncle Ronnie back home to us. We love you.
Well, this is hard to do, to stand up after that. The sounds outside tell us a couple of things. It's homecoming, and it's a football game in the making, and a football game that I hope that the university at the end of the game will raise the flag at the south end of the university. Just a couple of notes that I'd like to say to veterans. You know, I too am a 25-year vet of Vietnam too. And to Colonel Carlson, I'd like to say that we do hang a yellow ribbon, but we do so much more. You know, I don't think it can go unnoticed as you walk around this campus. For example, there's a brand new indoor training facility on the south side of the campus that's called the Veterans Memorial Training Center. Then next to that, there's an anchor that represents the V5, V12 program. And then next to that, the Mercer Birmingham building has a custom design wing on it for our very active and flourishing ROTC program. And the newly named Jeffrey B. Dodge Veterans Center on the north end of this campus. So, and I'm sure I've missed some stuff, but you can go from the north to the south end and tell that we do so much more than hang a yellow ribbon. And that's telling me I gotta hurry up. But a note to the veterans out there in the group, because I know there's a lot. You know, I can't speak for all veterans, but I think we're a humble lot. I think when someone comes up to us and says, we're a humble lot except when we're together telling war stories. But when someone comes up and says to us, thank you for your service, you know, you kind of drop your head and say, yeah, thank you, you know. Because really, we just thought we were doing what we were supposed to do. We were doing what our country called us to do. We're doing our job that our country needed of us, you know. But I won't embarrass veterans that are out there by asking you to stand up, because I've been asked to do that many times in audiences, and it is embarrassing. But I would ask you, though, to give the veterans in our audience a hand of applause. And Now, as we move on to this football game that we're going to win, I'd just like to say that what we're left with today after everyone leaves after homecoming, for those of us who continue to come to work here today, is a responsibility. A responsibility to make sure that the university remains a place of hope and promise for people, just like it was for you when you came to the University of Dubuque. And for those of us who come to work here every day, you know, we marvel too at the growth of the campus, and we marvel at how it's changed, but mostly we marvel in its historic roots and Christian virtues and values. And it's not that it's only our job to teach those Christian virtues and values to our students, but it's our job to treat each other on this campus with Christian virtues and values. So that is our responsibility. Congratulations to all of the award winners. And please head down to the stadium and root on the Spartans. Thank you. Can we get a benediction before we leave, please? It was a great and wonderful time together. So could, at the risk of stopping you for just a moment.
That's okay. Please stand. If you are able, go ahead and please stand. Now, I pray for our Spartans. Not that I think that maybe God is going to up there kind of wondering, you know, who's praying more? Are they praying more for UD or Warburg? But because I believe that our coaches and our athletes and our students, they do so many things the right way, that I hope and pray that they are rewarded with the success. And I tell you that because I want you to know that you can be proud of our current students, coming from somebody who has gotten to know so many of them. So I ask, I charge you, if it is worth doing, do it well. If it is worth doing, do it as unto the Lord, and receive this benediction. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you this day and every day. Hallelujah and amen. Go in peace.